my eyes. I am quite nearsighted. I suffer from an ailment.
An ailment?
It's called...
surgery?
Oh, no, Michelle. Astigmatism.
This is fantastic. Does this happen often? It's fairly to testify.
Only after you've made the arrest. For SDA, you're getting much too excited. Most of these new censorship laws are ridiculous. You can't arrest a woman for telling her eyes scurvy.
I am not trying to tell women anything. I realize I do not have my brilliant and learned colleagues' courtroom experience. I am fresh from the dull atmosphere of the laws. But yesterday I took an oath to uphold the law, and I believe that is the sole duty of a judge.
My dear friend, new colleague, it is not necessary to instruct us in the duties of a judge.
I am doing no such thing.
Why are you
lying? However, it has always been a part of my training to believe that if a law is wrong, it should and will be changed. But while that law exists, it must be respected. Now, if you policemen make these arrests, of course you take testimony from the witnesses.
No, monsieur.
Do you ever use photography in conjunction with the arrest?
No, monsieur.
Will you take me to your superior?
Yes, monsieur.
What is the
aim? What is this? Monsieur President, it's unfortunate. Or perhaps fortunate that this happened during my first day on the bench. But now I couldn't rest if I didn't do something about this. What's the name of that jazz song?
Balls of Party.
You're not showing up there.
Be careful, noble judge. There are many distractions in Omar. Her role is sidetracked by licentiousness.
That sort of thing couldn't possibly distract me.
Why not?
judge. Everybody says he's going to try to clean up Lamont.
Let him try. The stash will take care of him, too.
This stash?
She's smart. She won't let anyone stop us from dancing. She knows all the customers come to see us dance.
And you pay her for the privilege.
Well, the stash said one of these days, she's going to have us work for her like real dancers.
What about your job at the laundry?
Well, I'd give that up.
Give up? For the past 5 years, I have been temporarily dependent on your income. Now, when I am on the verge of starting ready to prepare an exhibition of my sculpture, I find myself abandoned.
No, it's not true!
Someday, history will remember you as the woman who lost faith in Boris Arjanijanaj.
Well, Mr. Borman,
care of them? How?
Depends. Some men like money, some girls, some wine. So I have a list.
A list?
A long list of all the fits in my mind. And next to each name, I write down what he likes.
There can't be such a list.
No. Come, I will show you. It is back in my office.
You know, you're a very resourceful woman.
Why, thank you. Business is not easy for a woman. One has to be a very good judge of character. Well, what's wrong?
I'm afraid it's only been one day.
Well, then you're not really a judge. Just say, you little judgy. After a while, you will learn to come straight into it. How much?
How much?
You can leave it to me. Why, this is twice as much as the sergeant gets.
Article 4, Section 12, Subdivision 2, Penal Code Amendment 1878. The commission with intent and premeditation of the aforesaid act shall be punishable by a sentence of not less than 5, nor more than 10 years in the penitentiary.
What's that?
The penalty for bribing an official.
You just want to persecute us. What have you against the girls and me?
Nothing.
What kind of Frenchman are you? You're a prude. Do you have a touch of English blood?
No.
Here you are, a handsome man with an excellent figure. I would assume you would not dislike girls.
I do not dislike girls. I'm tired of explaining my principles, and I certainly will not attempt to explain them to you.
Oh, miserable, unhappy man.
I am neither miserable nor unhappy.
No wife, no mistress?
What makes you say that?
If you were in love with someone, you would go easier on me.
I certainly would not.
Oh, miserable, I'm not.
Don't keep saying that.
Oh, God, nobody loves you, Mamita. What have you got not to be miserable about?
I don't know what you're talking about. I'm not unhappy, I have my life.
Mark my friends, this never would have happened during the Empire. The old emperor may have had his faults, but he did look good.
My wife says that...
Your wife is a fat pig.
True.
Claudine is already called.
Oh, I'm not sure. We each got a summons. We have to be in court on Friday.
Well, nothing bad can happen to anyone as lovely as you.
Oh, that judge, he has got a lump of ice in his belly.
That was a pistache. In my opinion, this is the most fortunate occurrence.
In your opinion? Oh, pistache, isn't Monsieur Hilaire Dubac the most famous art critic in Paris?
Not the most famous, just the most lovable. Enchanté, mademoiselle. This incident will make you famous. It will cause talk all over Paris.
Yes, and ruin me.
No, the talk will make everyone want to come here. We French are famous for our rare cuisine, but our favorite diet is the forbidden fruit, preferably raw. Now let's talk about your next trial.
And what would you have in mind?
Well, mademoiselle is one of the leading devotees of the four arts. I am in charge of that little annual horror called the Cat's Arts Ball.
The Cat's Arts Ball?
Yes. Last year we held it at the Élysée Montmartre, but I have decided that this year we shall hold it at the Ball du Paradis.
At my place?
Didn't that ball last year cause a lot of trouble?
Yes, but it made the Élysée Montmartre.
It was quite a party. I myself received 2 flesh wounds. Yes, our little ball is always named the faux pas.
What's that? I think it's dirty Latin.
As soon as possible. Now let's talk matter when you clean up that little matter in court.
The cats are full at my place. Thank you. I will go and tell the air. I have nothing to wear. You will win first round.
It's very sweet of you to do this for Pistache.
I did it for you. Claudine, may I take you home?
Oh, Boris will be taking you home.
Boris will be no problem. After all, husbands understand.
Oh, Boris isn't my husband.
Oh, dear. Then he is a problem.
Boris is a great artist. He's dying to meet you.
And I'm dying to take you home. I am, of course, referring to my home.
Your home? Oh, Boris wouldn't like you going to your place.
Would you like it?
I haven't thought about it.
Well, think about it.
I don't want to.
Claudine, what's wrong? I'm really one of the most charming men in Paris.
Oh. I know.
But really, if you did, you would hurl yourself at me. I know. Everyone. I go everywhere. I do everything. Darling, I'd be virtually an education. From down to up, about this town,
tonight.
Oh, no. No, if you don't mind, I'd rather that Claudine...
Fine. Come along with us.
Oh, no. I don't want you alone. You see, monsieur, you have an extremely powerful personality.
All my life.
Yes, well... I'm afraid you would influence me about your work. I would much rather hear about you from Claudine.
Well, if it would not be too dull for you...
Oh, no, it won't. Oh, Claudine, we shall go to supper and discuss. Boris.
No, no! I mean, maybe Boris should come along.
Oh, Claudine, you do not want to offend Monsieur Jussac.
Go along, have supper with him. You will tell him about my work.
Heard Monsieur Jussac. Because of my personality, he does not want to be there while he is eating. You want Monsieur Jussac to help, don't you?
I believe an impartial observer would say that you kissed me.
because they want to hold the cats are scalded.
The cats are? You're insane!
Insane? Why, this is the greatest opportunity of my life. And I won't let you take it away from me.
Do you know what you're talking about? That ball caused a riot last year. If you have that ball at your place, you'll lose your license permanently. And probably spend a lot more time here than you can possibly imagine.
I understand you now. You don't care about the law. You want to tell everyone how to live.
That's not true.
Well, there will be a castle ball, whether you want it or not. No one can tell me how to live. Sincerely, we overthrew at the ball of the Bastille. If you tell a French love what to do, or if you tell what not to do, he will only give a look at you, but the look will be nasty. For France will always go with a gold on her way, and to every form of censorship, the French will always say, Vive la liberté!
right there from now. Thank you, Miss Yen. Right there will be fine, thank you. We will not uncover them until Monsieur Jussac arrives. That will be a great moment, huh?
You're sure Jussac is coming here today?
Of course I am sure. Slonim is bringing him.
Oh?
Oh.
Oh, oh. What is the meaning of oh, oh?
Nothing, just oh.
Oh, well, I detect something somewhat sinister. I know what you are referring to.
You are referring to Claudine and Jussac.
I know what you are thinking. You are thinking, oh, well, Claudine is seeing too much of Jussac. You do not think it is absolutely necessary that she spend every single moment with him. You think that, don't you?
No, Horace.
But I do. And Jussac, you stuffing Claudine's head with nonsense about her dancing, telling her she is just as talented as I am. Well, I need Jussac's help, but as soon as I am recognized, I will show me something.
How do you want me to stand?
Silently. Where's Claudine?
She's coming!
Claudine, how beautiful you look.
Yes, isn't she lovely?
How do you like it, Forrest?
Where's Monsieur Jussac?
He'll be here in a minute.
Wonderful!
How do you like it?
Oh, a new umbrella?
Is that all you
noticed? So expensive looking. How?
Monsieur Jussac is visiting.
Oh.
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 Monsieur Jussac said that one day I will be the toast of Paris, and I might as well begin to look at it.
Well, I am sure that is very kind of Monsieur Jussac, but your clothes are my responsibility.
But you never buy me any good clothes.
You do not make enough money. Making a fool of yourself.
Making a fool of myself? I'd love to make a career of dancing. I dance so well. I go so far.
not be bourgeois, Miss Cracker. Just think of these things as a little gift I made to Claudine out of gratitude.
Why should you be grateful to Hart?
Because she enabled me to get to know you.
Oh, how charming!
I think we girls are going to leave now. I hope you love everything you see.
I do now.
Au revoir. Does anybody want me for anything?
Don't look at me, darling. I just climbed 5 flights of stairs.
Monsieur Juzac, while you are waiting, perhaps you might have a few moments to look at some of my canvases. You know, there's been a lot of talk about my work in cubo-pointillism.
Cubo-pointillism?
Oh, yes. It's a technique I've developed, completely my own. You see, I use the wooden end of the brush.
Now, monsieur.
Oh, I'm sorry, dear Boris. I was just telling monsieur...
Another time, dear Neofin.
Dear Boris.
Now, monsieur, to begin, let me say you are not going to see all my works at once. You will be overwhelmed. Instead, they will be presented to you one by one, like the dishes in a delightful repast.
Quite amusing.
It is not meant to be. This is tragic. Oh. One of my early efforts in symbolic sculpture, I call it fish drowning.
Very...
Meaning she symbolizes all of life. The water represents the violent forces of nature and civilization. The fish is man struggling against a sea of despair, but the struggle is useless. And one day this brave fish must drown.
Why?
I will bring you something simpler.
Monsieur Juzac, this is a still life of a half-eaten orange. Notice the details of the teeth marks.
Dear Neofin, dear Boris. Now, Monsieur Juzac, a work of my real theory. I call it Dancing Woman. Is she not exquisite?
What there is of her?
Oh, well, I have dispensed with the body. That would have been conventional. By doing this, I obtain a distillation, a synthesis of the dance. I create a sense of space and mobility. And besides, I say makeup on marble. Thank you. Now, be sure to that a work of which I am very proud. Strong dynamic. Yet shows a good deal of classic influence. All the symbolism of this one is obvious.
Oh yes, I know it's obvious. But would you mind explaining it to stupid little me?
This represents the hand of man lifting the art of the past from the shadow of antiquity.
Oh, what do you call it?
The hand of man lifting the art of the past from the shadow of antiquity.
Naturally. Well, if that's all your work, I'd better run along.
Oh, wait, Monsieur, there is one more thing I must show you. Hercule, Neofin, quickly!
Monsieur Juzac, perhaps while you're waiting, you care to hear some of my work.
No.
This is a short poem called To a Grecian. Oh, noble torsoed king of Hellas, amber muscles broiled by Spartan sun, glory to 20 head of jet, jet, jet. Proud in June with myriad drops of sweat, sweat, sweat. Gorgon gone, lost or lost, dead, oh dead.
We are ready, oh ready. Now, Monsieur Juzac, it has long been my belief that an artist's work should complement each other. Each individual creation should be like a movement in a symphony. Beautiful in itself, yet able to join in a glorious entity. Do you understand me?
Not at all.
Then, I will show you. Behold, a symphony of my masterpiece.
Good God, what is that?
my contention that the symbolism of a mermaid is too frustrating.
Is that me?
Oh, Lizzie Topaz!
Thank you.
And yet I came here tonight because I was worried about
you. What are you trying to sell me?
This.
Thank you.
after the stable has been mopped.
Tell us, man.
What are you going to do?
I'm going down to straighten this matter out.
I'd wait, if I were you.
Wait?
He's right. This paper says there's going to be a judicial inquiry as soon as they find you.
But I have to face it eventually.
So wait until eventually. In the meantime, things will cool off.
The police have it in for you. If you go rushing down there right now, they'll crucify you just to make themselves look like heroes.
Take a couple of days off. You could stay right here.
Maybe I should wait a few days until I can get in touch with some of my colleagues.
Right. In a few days, it'll all be forgotten. Oh, yes, I once wrote some verse that spoke of the fleeting memory of man. I called it evanescence.
Fading, fleeting, fleeting, fading, timeless, yet never evanescent.
Yes?
Away, away, pain away, and in a forest burn.
world of art is always an exhilarating experience for a critic.
He writes beautifully.
One always envies the sensations and emotions that a Galileo must have felt when, on peering through his primitive telescope, he first stumbled upon the tiny sparks of light that meant new stars in the firmament.
Oh, nice point he makes.
Consequently, it was with great anticipatory excitement that I lately journeyed to Montmartre to view the work of a new star. I went to find my new star. I was miserably disappointed. I was miserably disappointed.
No!
The artist's name is Horace Ogeny Janage. Mark this name well, or it is one you will wish to forget. Horace has spelled your name wrong.
Oh, don't try to cheer me up.
His style, if style can be called, is shabby and eclectic, cluttered with neo-impressionism, and made unbearable by mediocre execution.
This is awful!
Horace, this is just as painful for us as it is for you.
Read that last part again.
Made unbearable by mediocre...
Go on!
Wherever there is a sign of creative concept, it's been buried under the grossest banality and pointed out by the inept use of material. There is really nothing more to say about this man's work. A good deal of it could be attributed to lack of taste or talent. I, however, will be charitable and attribute it to insanity. Horace, Juzak cannot mean these things.
But he does, and I guess he is right.
Don't say that.
I mean it.
Horace, I believe Juzak has written these things about you because there is something between him and Claudine.
If only I could believe that was all there was to...
Wait a minute.
What are you saying?
Are you saying that you sat deliberately with intent to insult? Insulted me?
Yes!
Me? A Bulgarian Ogeny Janage? Be there, get to
Horace!
Have you had blood?
He's never thanked you,
Horace! Wait, let me go!
Wait a minute, Horace!
I'm Horace! You will have your revenge.
How?
You will challenge him.
Challenge him?
A duel!
A duel?
Are you crazy?
Your name?
any of your business.
Of course it's my business. I'm not just anyone. I'm the one who got you into trouble in the first place.
Yes, you are. And as you so very wisely told me the other night, go away.
I won't. If it don't make you any happier, now I can punish those. I've lost my license permanently. I'm out of business because of you.
Oh, I am sorry. Please forgive me.
And also, I took your advice and gave back that money. And I could have used that money for my new cafe.
Your new cafe?
Yes, a cafe concept with entertainment and everything. After last night, your mind should be very quiet. So I figured the naughty cafe should do very well.
But you have no license.
Not for a cafe, but I can get them for a laundry. This will be a laundry during the day and a cafe.
Well, I wish you luck.
Say, you hate me and, well, I don't think very much of you. Why don't we go into business together?
Exactly, what are you made of?
You've been close enough to find out.
Forestier?
Judge Barrier!
Is that you?
Well, it's the new Forestier.
See, you also have a new tailor.
I imagine you were surprised to hear from me.
You seemed to disapprove of me.
I needed someone like you. My old friends are all so self-righteous and proud. But you're such
an old bastard.
You're human.
You are also human.
I can be, but I'm not very good at it. When I get human, I get too damned human.
So it appears.
Well, I've been avoiding facing an inquiry until I could speak to you.
That's wise. There's a lot of trouble.
I knew there would be some difficulty.
Difficulty? You've been suspended from the bench. You'll no doubt be suspended from the bar. You've been expelled from your legal society. You've been dropped by two clubs. Right now, I think you're the only man in France who would be rejected by the Foreign Legion.
But, Paul, as soon as I get a hearing...
You won't get a real hearing.
What do I do?
Well, if it was I would temporarily take a small trip. Perhaps Siam. Then, when things arrange themselves...
This is monstrous! I'm being deprived of everything I've got without due process of law, without a jury. That's what's been happening to those girls in Montmartre. They don't get jury trials.
That's an old story.
Well, I'm going to get a jury trial.
How?
By committing a crime.
What?
Not a very serious one. Now, give me some money. Suppose I want to become partners with someone who runs an unlicensed cafe for illegal dancing. And suppose after a week or so, we got the place raided by the police and went before a jury. What do you suppose would happen?
You'd wind up in a blaze of glory.
That's what I'm hoping. Thanks, Paul. I'm going to arrange a partnership. I'll see you in a few days.
Aristide, will this party you're talking about consent to getting arrested?
Why, of course. Well, maybe I won't tell her for a few days.
Her? One lives to see everything.
Besides, come on. I want to talk business with you. It seems I'll be staying in Montmartre for the next few weeks, and I've decided to go into the partnership with you.
Aristide!
I'll give you all the money you need, but it must be an equal partnership.
Oh, yes.
I share all the decisions, an equal partner.
Absolutely. I'll give you 25% of the profits.
I must have 50.
But you were just putting up the money.
It's very important that I take an equal share of the profits. And if we are arrested, I'll also take an equal share of the blame.
Take 25% of the profits, and you can have all the blame.
to become a chief mackerel of a man and to forget about everything I ever believed in.
Why do you say that?
Because you never give anything away.
Now this is a marvelous place for a duel.
Yes.
For the first to arrive.
Juzak, he's in here.
I will not wait any longer.
Quiet. We'll have the police up here.
What is this? What's going on? What's the matter with Boris? He looks like he's going to die.
Naturally.
Eustache, you will have to leave. We have to stay.
This is an affair of honor.
You mean Boris is going to duel with someone?
Boris has challenged the mayor Juzak. It's true.
True.
That's ridiculous.
True.
People do not duel anymore.
They do, but you do not know about it. Boris must do this. Juzak has made it the laughingstock of Paris.
But how will a duel... Suppose Boris gets killed?
Then Hilaire Juzak will be ashamed for the rest of his life.
A poor man!
You're really serious about this. I'd better get Claudine. You men are all stupid!
Claudine will stop this if she comes.
If only I could believe that. Claudine does not care about me anymore. She does not love me anymore. Still, I must go through with it.
Boris, you'll be all right, believe me. These days, duels are just a formality.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Who is that?
The doctor.
What do we need a doctor for?
A formality.
Again, a formality. My funeral will also be a formality.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
My train?
What are those?
Swords.
I know what they are, but we were supposed to use pistols.
Oh, I forgot to tell you. Monsieur Juzak, as the chair of the party, had choice of weapons.
But we were going to use pistols. Pistols at 30 paces, which by the way is too close anyhow.
But Monsieur Juzak chose swords.
And I will compromise. Sword at 30 paces.
Boris, you're embarrassing us.
Oh, well, Boris, the bitch.
You gentlemen are ready. Quite.
We are ready.
He is ready. What is Juzak going to use?
At least he came up here to defend his honor, whereas I... young man can do is change his mind when he knows he's right. Thank you.
Forrest! Oh!
As you wish, mademoiselle.